This is a very busy year for you here, right?
Very busy year indeed, yeah. I've got three films here at the festival, and I've been told that I now have the award for most films at one single Fright Fest, so I take that as an extreme honor.
Yeah, I mean, Barbara Crampton, she's always in a few, so, you know, that's good going to out Barbara.
Oh, right, yeah, I would never challenge Barbara's territory, so I will happily bow out of that competition.
Obviously, you've done the score and that for the three films. They're all very different films. How did you approach each of them?
How did I what?
How did you approach them? You know, one of them's a Western. I Trapped the Devil is a.
They all had three very different approaches. So I had originally read the script for The Dark Red, and I wrote the score entirely from the script. Because of timing and the window of opportunity for that one, I wrote entirely based on my conversations with the director about the story and reading the script. With I Trapped the Devil, they had a cut that I could watch, and Josh opted to just send me the cut without music. He said, I like what you do, we don't really have much money, but if you would consider just watching it, I'll let you do whatever you want to do. I said, okay, so I watched just a cut with no music and thought about where it might fit. And then in the case of The Wind, it was kind of a combination of the two. I had read the script, but I didn't actually come on board until they had shot. So I saw, you know, some rough footage and things like that when they were first assembling the edit, and I was able to dive into it right at the beginning of post-production.
So what was, once you'd seen I Trapped the Devil, what was your approach to, you know, did you instantly have an idea of what sort of instruments you wanted to use? How did that come together?
Well, you know, the logistics determine that a lot of times. So when you're dealing with choices about instrumentation, a lot of times budget and time restraints, you have to factor those in. And on that film, I thought, it's so contained. There's three characters in a house and maybe something else downstairs. I needed to do something that maybe I could do all myself. And so I think we had the budget to hire like one cellist and one violin player, you know, and everything. I said, can I do a score of just instruments I play, which is primarily guitar and piano? So it's a lot of design sounds, synthesizers, guitars and piano, and then just a couple of wonderful string players who let me punish them by just layering and layering and layering. And that's kind of how you make those decisions. Sometimes you let the situation or the circumstances dictate a path, and then you have to figure out how to help tell the story within that.
And how did you first get into film composing? How easy is it to get into that role?
Well, I got into it entirely by accident. So it was easy for me in that it wasn't ever supposed to happen. I was in college. I was about 19 or 20, and I didn't know anything about it or making music in general, really. I was fumbling around with a guitar. And I met a group of kids who were making a student film, and someone suggested to them that I do their music. And I tried to convince them that was a terrible idea because I didn't know anything about scoring a film, and they said, well, we don't know anything about making a film, so why should that scare you? And I really had no way to argue with that, so I was in. And one leads to another, and one leads to another, and before you know it, you look back, and for 20 years, you've been scoring movies, figuring it out as you go.
And do you have anything else in the pipeline? You know, you're going to be bringing six films next year to Fright Fest?
God, I hope not, because that would be a very rough year between now and then. I have two films that I'm working on at the moment. One of them is I'm reuniting with, a couple years ago I scored The Ritual with David Bruckner. I'm working on David's new film called The Night House, and that's coming around in 2020. I just finished a documentary that's coming out in 2020 about the strange and unique world of professional taxidermists. Bet you didn't think I was going to say that.
No, not at all. So is approaching a documentary different to a feature film?
Yeah, incredibly different. And I really, really enjoyed the opportunity to work on documentaries because you learn so much more about certain things that are sort of like tricks that work consistently on narrative don't always work on documentaries and vice versa. It's also interesting that in a documentary I feel a different level of responsibility to the way I'm affecting emotionally a scene, because with characters in a narrative your job is to just whatever's best for heightening the drama on screen. But sometimes you can do that in a way that's a little dishonest when it's an actual person talking about their life or something that's real. And so you have to approach it with a little bit, a different sort of attention and care, which is a good challenge.
Well, enjoy the rest of your Fright Fest, and I hope you get to have a rest.
Thank you.